was vividly vibrant.
Thank you, children, for taking us into the realms of Andhra Pradesh, Orissa, Punjab, Chhattisgarh, and Mizoram.
It was a probe into the agricultural practices and tools also.
Farmers don't just work till the sun goes down. They work till their job gets done.
My grandfather used to say that once in your life, you may need a lawyer, a doctor, or a policeman. But thrice a day, you need a farmer.
Not only your grandfather, there was a man ages ago who thought of this. He is legendary, his personality iconic, known for his simplicity. Now, I would like to take you to Varanasi, Uttar Pradesh, where a humble acorn has grown into a mighty oak.
It was then these ideas about farmers and soldiers sprouted.
We might know him only as a short-lived prime minister, but in fact, he was the one who brought revolution in the lives of farmers and soldiers. He was such a person that his coffin was carried by the then prime minister of Pakistan. Now, we go back in history to envisage such a personality.
Before that, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to seek your attention and announce that Subha Niketan School is conducting a selfie competition on Facebook. Your child must take a selfie with you and post it in their Facebook page or in their parents' Facebook page and tag our school by using hashtag Subha Niketan School or hashtag SNS Annual Day 2018. Thank you. Once again, I'm repeating. Subha Niketan School is conducting a Facebook competition, a selfie competition on Facebook. Your parent, your child must take a selfie with you and they must post it in their Facebook page or their parents' Facebook page.
A small railway town 7 miles away from Varanasi, Uttar Pradesh. His parents were Sharda Prasad Srivastav and mother Ram Dulari Devi. His mother faced a sorrow and painful situation while he was just 3 months old. A little boy reunited with his mother. His father, Sharda Prasad Srivastav, a school teacher by profession, passed away when he was just 2 years old. His mother, Ram Dulari Devi, took him and his two sisters to their grandfather's house. That little boy had to face a very tough time for completing his primary education. Every day he used to swim twice across the river Ganga with his books tied on his head, as he does not have money to afford to go in a boat.
Master ji.
हाँ बैठो बैठो.
धन्यवाद मास्टर जी.
चलो बच्चों अपनी अपनी हाजिरी बोलो. गुप्ता. अश्लागन.
हाजिर हूँ मास्टर जी.
श्रीवास्तव. श्रीवास्तव. श्रीवास्तव तुम जवाब क्यों नहीं दे रहे हो?
मास्टर जी आप मेरा नाम लाल बहादुर कह के बुलाइए. मेरा कुल का नाम लेकर बुलाना मुझे अच्छा नहीं लगता.
ठीक है चलो बच्चे अपनी अपनी किताबें निकालो. लाल बहादुर आज फिर से तुम अपनी किताब लेके नहीं आए?
नहीं मास्टर जी.
अगर कल तुम किताब लेके नहीं आए तो मैं तुझे कक्षा के बाहर भेज दूंगा.
जी मास्टर जी.
That day for the whole night, Lal Bahadur wrote the entire textbook sitting under street light. Next day.
Pranam Master Ji.
हाँ बैठो बैठो.
धन्यवाद Master Ji.
Lal Bahadur, आज तुम अपनी किताब लेके आए?
हाँ Master Ji.
दिखाओ. ये तो लिखी हुई है
शिक्षक जी मैंने पूरा किताब अपने हाथों से लिखा है। हम बहुत गरीब बेपुस्तक खरीदने के लिए पैसा नहीं थे, इसलिए मुझे ऐसा करना पड़ा।
अगर
शाबाश मेरे बच्चे, शाबाश।
अगर तुम्हें पढ़ाई लिखाई का इतना ही शौक है तो मैं तुम्हारी मदद करूँगा।
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद मास्टर जी आपके दस स्वभाव के लिए, लेकिन मुझे किसी की उपकार लेना अच्छा नहीं लगता।
तो फिर तुम एक काम करो, तुम मेरे बच्चों की पढ़ाई में मदद करो और इस तरह मुझे तुम्हारी मदद करने दो।
जी मास्टर जी।
इंस्पायर्ड बाय हिज टीचर मिश्रास पेट्रियटिज्म, लाल बहादुर टुक डीप इंटरेस्ट इन द फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल। One day, he along with his friend Nitin Eslawat went to hear Mahatma Gandhi's speech in Benares. Inspired by Mahatma calls for the students to withdraw from government schools and joined in various movements. Later, Lal Bahadur joined in Kashi Vidyapeeth in Benares and graduated in philosophy and ethics in 1925. Now we call upon Lal Bahadur to come and take the scholar award Shastry. Shastry is the title awarded to Lal Bahadur by Kashi Vidyapeeth for graduating in philosophy and ethics in distinction. But the title Shastry has stuck in the minds of the people as a part of his name. Shastri ji not only graduated in ethics but also followed ethics in his life. Let us watch one example during his marriage.
आपको दहेज में क्या चाहिए?
मैं दहेज के सख्त खिलाफ हूँ।
लेकिन दहेज देना हमारा रिवाज है, बेटी के शादी में बेटी के साथ दहेज देना।
अगर आपके ही रिवाज है तो मुझे 5 मीटर का कादी का कपड़ा और एक चाका दीजिए।
ठीक है।
On 16 May 1928, Shastri ji married Lalita Devi from Mirzapur. The couple were blessed with 4 sons and 2 daughters. In 1930, Lal Bahadur Shastri became the secretary of local unit of Congress. He actively participated in Salt Satyagraha movement. He did door-to-door campaign not to pay land revenues and taxes to the British.
Simon, go back!
Simon, go back!
Bande Mataram! Inkulab Jindabad!
For this, he was arrested and spent 9 years in jail. Even though he was in jail for 9 years, he was not depressed and utilized the time by reading famous philosophers and social reformers like Swami Vivekananda, Guru Nanak, Lenin, who changed the face of the society. And he also translated autobiography of Madame Curie, who discovered radium, into Hindi language. And at the same time, he was also in touch with his family through letters. And one day, he wrote a letter to his wife.
Lalita, tum kaise ho? Bacche kaise hai? Tum meri chinta mat karo. Main yahan theek hoon. Kya tumka pension ke paise se ghar chalane mein dikkat to nahi ho rahi hai? Agar kuch dikkat ho to mujhe patra likh dena.
मैं यहाँ ठीक हूँ, आप मेरी चिंता मत कीजिए। बच्चे स्कूल जा रहे हैं और अच्छी तरह पढ़ रहे हैं। पेंशन से 50 रुपए मिल रहा है, मैं 40 रुपए से ही घर चला रही हूँ और हर महीने 10 रुपए बचत कर रही हूँ।
Now I should write to People Servant Society to send only 40 rupees as my family is able to save only 10 rupees so that it could be given to a needy.
This shows his honesty and responsibility towards the society.
Finally, India got independence in the year 1947. Even after independence, Lal Bahadur Shastri played a crucial role in Indian political system. He was appointed as parliamentary secretary to Chief Minister Govind Vallabh Pant in Uttar Pradesh, and later he was appointed as Minister of Police and Transport. Now let us see the changes he brought in the system.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, there's a lot of disturbance in the city, creating a public nuisance. We are unable to control them. We need an order from you to disperse them.
How are you planning to disperse?
By using Lathi Charj, sir.
No, officer. They're not criminals to use Lathi Charj. They are the people of our country who are fighting for their rights. And they order you to use water jets to disperse the public. And from now onwards, whenever required to disperse.
Okay, sir.
So water jets was the new system what Lal Bahadur Shastri has introduced in India, and not only that, he was the first person to appoint women conductors. He also served the nation as General Secretary of the All India Congress Committee with Jawaharlal Nehru as the Prime Minister. Impressed by the efforts in reforming the State Police Department, one day Jawaharlal Nehru invited Shastri to his office. Let us see what may be the reason.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Please be seated. Shastriji, I am very much impressed by the changes brought by you in the Uttar Pradesh. Now, I would like to render service to the nation as a railway minister.
Thank you very much, sir. I'll do my little best to the nation, sir.
As a minister of railways, he made efforts to reduce vast disparity between first and third classes and provided more facilities even in ordinary compartments, which we are following even today. But unfortunately, two consecutive accidents occurred in Mehboob Nagar and Tamil Nadu, killing hundreds of people, which led Shastri ji to resign.
I am accepting Lal Bahadur Shastri's resignation, not because he was responsible for what happened, but to set an example in the constitutional prosperity. And no one could wish a better comrade than Lal Bahadur Shastri, a man of highest integrity and devoted to ideals.
During Nehru's illness, Shastri ji was a minister without portfolio, and he played a constructive role in governance of the country without any portfolio.
Shastri ji, you're going to take a responsible role in the selection of candidates during elections. And this time, you attend communal meetings on my behalf.
Definitely, sir. We'll meet again.
Yes.
Later, he became the Home Minister, and people used to call him as the homeless Home Minister because he did not have a house of his own. Even as a Home Minister, he thought of bringing some changes in the society. Let us watch the initiation he has taken to trigger the problem.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Please take your seat. Mr. Santanan, as far as I observe, there are a lot of corruption in various departments, and I decided to form a committee for the prevention, which will be headed by you.
Thank you very much, sir, for considering me. I'll do my best to fulfill my responsibility.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
The country's Prime Minister, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, passed away in the year 1964. After Nehru's death, Congress Party President Kamraj played a crucial role in making Lal Bahadur Shastri as second Prime Minister of India. He faced many challenges after becoming the Prime Minister, and the most important one was food crisis. Those were the days India was facing a severe drought situation and literally begging grains from USA. Let us watch how he solved the problem.
Good morning, sir.
Good evening. All
good
of
evening,
you
sir.
Please take your seat.
Thank you, sir.
The reason for gathering is to discuss a serious problem of food crisis what India is facing today. And I wanted all the scientists here to come up with various solutions so that we are self-reliant and not to occur the situation in future. And Mr. Swaminathan,
sir,
you will be the head of the team to take up the responsibility.
It's my pleasure, sir, that you've chosen me for this task. I'll do my best to come up with the solutions.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. As the problem of food crisis is very severe and from today onwards, I skip a meal in a day and I urge the nation to skip a meal in a week so that it could be given to a needy. Not only that, I have cleared my lawn into mini farmland and I expect the people of the country to use their private land in their houses to grow food crops. So let us solve the problem to some extent.
This made India self-sufficient, and that is how he was called as Farmer's Prime Minister. Around the same time, Shastri ji had begun to observe a revolutionary movement in Anand village in Gujarat in the form of milk cooperatives. He personally invited Mr. Varghese Kurian, who was the general manager at Amul and was leading the milk revolution in Gujarat.
Good morning, sir.
Good evening. Please take your seat.
Mr. Kurian, I appreciate you for the revolution chain you bought in milk cooperatives in Gujarat, and I hope you to bring the same chain throughout the country.
Definitely, sir. I'll do my best.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
This triggered the White Revolution, also called as Operation Flood, which drastically increased milk production through India through the means of several cooperatives which were administered by villagers themselves, thereby producing large-scale employment as well. The most tough challenge faced by him was war with Pakistan in 1965. One of the reasons for provocation was that Pakistan underestimated Lal Bahadur Shastri and assumed that India would quickly decay after Nehru's death. And hence, it was the right time to strike, and Shastri ji was the only prime minister who entered war field. Now let us see the enraged Lal Bahadur Shastri.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Mr. Commander, I order you to... Mr. Commander, it doesn't matter if we are destroyed. We'll fight to last to maintain the high honor of Indian nation and its flag.
Okay, sir. Definitely. I'll go as per your order. Thank you, sir. Jai Hind.
Force will be met with the force. Our Indian national tricolor will survive only if our nation survives. Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan.
He popularized the slogan Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, which has turned to be a national slogan. Indo-Pakistan war ended in 1965 after United Nations passed a resolution demanding a ceasefire. The Russian Prime Minister invited the Prime Minister of India, Lal Bahadur Shastri, and Pakistan President Ayub Khan for peace treaty. Now let us all go to Tashkent.
Dear Mr. President, dear Mr. Prime Minister, we are glad to meet you, the outstanding leaders of the Asiatic countries, India and Pakistan, at Tashkent, the capital of the Uzbek Socialist Republic. With the complete satisfaction, the President of India and Prime Minister of Pakistan established cooperation for putting an end to the conflict between India and Pakistan. Thank you.
It is a great pleasure to me that the very warm reception of the Tashkent people made us feel very moving. We immediately had accepted your invitation to take part in the Tashkent meeting. We shall be able to open a new chapter in history of the India-Pakistan relationship. Thank you.
My delegation and I was deeply moved by that warm and spontaneous reception by the people of the Uzbek Republic capital. Tashkent was chosen as a place for our future and is recalling the past and at the same time denoting the future. Thank you.
When Lal Bahadur Shastri passed away in 1966, he had no house on his name nor any land in his possession. He had only left behind a government loan which he had taken to buy a Fiat car after he became Prime Minister. After his death, the bank asked his wife Lalita Shastri for repayment of the loan, which she repaid from the family pension. And so was gone the tiny, tidy figure, a soul that had lived a perfect purity of thought, word and deed. He never sought power, he never worked for it. And yet, power and authority came in search of him. Fame set a crown on his head. The short man grew into a colossus and a leader who filled the four corners of the world with the fame of India.
Let us see a few memorials of Lal Bahadur Shastri. Lal Bahadur Shastri was posthumously awarded Bharat Ratna. Vijayghat is his resting place built in Delhi. Lal Bahadur Shastri, National Academy of Administration at Uttarakhand. Lal Bahadur Shastri Institute of Management at Delhi. Shastriji Indo-Canadian Institute in Canada. Shastriji House at Ramnagar in Varanasi is converted into Biographical Museum. Varanasi International Airport at Uttar Pradesh. A street is named after on his name in the city of Tashkent, Uzbekistan.
Almaty Dam is renamed as Lal Bahadur Shastri Sagar in Karnataka. MV Lal Bahadur Shastri, a cargo ship, is named after him. All India Lal Bahadur Shastri Hockey Tournament is held every year since 1991. RBI released coins in denomination of 5 during his birth century celebrations. The Reserve Bank has issued rupees 100 coin in 2011 to mark the 100th birth anniversary. The government of India released stamps on his name. Thank you.
Lal Bahadur Shastri was a man who was down to earth, honest to the core, dignified and diligent.
His demeanor is simple and straightforward.
Shastri ji is open, frank and very genuine.
Though he was confronted because of his difficulties, he never stooped down because of his self-respect.
Let us walk in his footsteps. That's the real tribute to such a man.
Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan.
Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan.
Wow, yep. What a dynamic theme.
Yes, it's an eye-opener.
All these phenomenal acts really inspire me to either become a soldier or a farmer.
We have all chosen different streams in plus one and plus two.
I thought of becoming a soldier, but I neither chose MPC nor BIPC. I have chosen BAE.
Any stream you choose would enable you to become either a soldier or a farmer.
I would be a soldier because he volunteers to put himself in harm's way selflessly.
I wish to serve people, and as my stream is BIPC, I'll go on the agricultural side. Do you know, friends, the army itself marches on its belly.
In that case, I do think the farmer serves more than a soldier. He is the supreme and it is one of the oldest professions.
It is really a task of pride to serve our motherland.
Yes, the farmer gives us peace of meal and the soldier provides peace of mind.
Are you sure to become a soldier or a farmer? My parents have a lot of hopes on me, so I'm not able to decipher.
Happening, children? Why are you confused?
Ma'am, I have always dreamt of becoming a doctor and now I'm in a dilemma.
And ma'am, my father wants me to look after his business.
My parents are having lots of hopes on me. Now I'm afraid that I would fail in reaching their expectations, ma'am.
Ma'am, what about our dreams and aspirations?
Are these two the only professions to serve our motherland, ma'am?
Just wait and see. And you know what to do.
Okay, ma'am.